Hey guys, welcome back to Magic TV. My name's Craig. It is Monday. It's 9 o'clock. It's time for a 5x5. This is where I take five subjects related to magic. I spend 5 minutes talking about each subject and then move on to the next subject. It's quick. It's snappy. You never know what you're going to get. Well, today I've got another special 5x5. And this 5x5 special is all about Wayne Goodman. Now, I was very lucky to have Wayne come and visit the office this week. He was here for 2 or 3 days and he was filming content for the Netflix. He's filmed a ton of magic tricks. He's filmed a ton of theory. Some of the best content we've got on the Netflix. It's amazing. We're going to start officially putting out Wayne's content as of next week. Just the one course that is put together on stage fright is a game changer for anyone that has nerves when they go and perform. And that will be on his launch lineup, which is coming up next Monday. Anyway, with that being said, today I'm going to be doing a Wayne Goodman special. Now, if you're a regular to this channel, you'll know on a 5x5 a few weeks ago, I did a Nemid Phoenix special and I took Nemid out for a meal. I asked him to perform 5 of his favorite card tricks and then I just did the performance for them. I showed the performance footage and I talked about why they're such good choices of card trick. Well, I'm doing the same thing here with Wayne. I took Wayne out for a meal with Nemid and with Matt from my office, from the Matt test, and I got Wayne to perform to Matt, and I filmed it, and I'm gonna talk about what I think about his choices. So these are 5 of Wayne's top favorite card tricks when he's out performing. Let's break them down. So the first trick we're gonna be looking at is basically just card jazzing. You know, every single card magician, every single close-up magician has that trick where it's kind of their 1,000-timer, as Greg Wilson would call it. You know, a trick where a card comes to the top. It might be an ambitious card. It might be a card in the box. It might be a series of color changes. Just something where there's a lot of visual moments to it. Something that you can do as an opener that's really going to grab people's attention. It's used as a display of skill. It grabs people. You know, every close-up magician has something like that. Well, this is Wayne's version of that. Now, I want you to pay close attention to the top change that he uses. Wayne's got a very unique top change that I've never seen before. And in this routine, he actually displays that top change. He's taught it for the net trick. So very, very soon on the net tricks, he's teaching his top change. Normally, the top change is done kind of invisibly. As you say, hold your hand out, you do the top change. With Wayne's top change, it happens as he comes up like this. So as he comes up and looks at the card, he's already changed it. It's the same technique, but he's changed the moment that it happens. And to be honest, I think it's one of the greatest innovations with the top change that I've seen since learning the original. Now, have a look at this routine. One thing that you can tell from checking out this routine is you can see that Wayne is an absolute workhorse of a close-up magician. You can see his stuff works and is high impact. He understands, and if there's one thing I want you guys to understand here, he understands the concept of hit him fast, hit him hard, boom, boom, boom. There's so many moments of magic in this routine. There's color changes, there's this, there's that, there's the other. And also, I want you to see how he uses the final slight. So at the very, very end, he does that switch, that toss switch. The only person I've ever seen really use that in the real world is Bill Malone. And he does it, and I've seen him do it. He's performed it in the same night he was performing to a bunch of lay people. I've seen him do this again and again and again, and it kills. Now, I was filming at a slightly weird angle, so you might see what's going on there, but from everybody's angle, it was just amazing. It was a really beautiful thing to see. I've never seen anyone do that toss switch in the real world before, and Matt was just blown away by it. So let's have a look at the first routine. It's kind of one of Wayne's 1,000-timers. There's a lot of magic. It's just all over the place, and it's really awesome.
Hey, Matt, how you doing?
I'm doing good, dude.
I want to show you one of my favorite tricks to do, and it's a little sequence of events that we're going to run through, so hopefully something magical happen. First of all the cards are different, is that correct?
Yes.
Oh yeah, they are, that's the wrong, too late now. Okay, I just want you to choose a card. You can have any card that you want. Okay, we're gonna give the cards a quick cut and cut a couple of shuffles. And all I'm gonna do is I'm gonna flick through the corners of the card like this. And whenever you want, I just want you to say stop and remember the card that you stop at. Now as I flick through, don't just say stop just yet, you can see they're all different, yeah? It's not one of those special decks where you go one way or the other. So as I go through, so I'm gonna look away, just say stop.
Stop.
Is that card there?
Yeah.
You know what it is? 100%.
Yeah.
Just keep saying it over inside your head, just to yourself though. Just keep repeating it over and over and over and over and over. Like, I don't know, like four spades, four spades, four spades, okay? Now I'm gonna, what? What happened? Was that your card? A lucky guess. Okay, I'm on fire here. Reach in and just take out a card. Just grab one.
Wait a sec.
No, that's fine, it's fine. Probably just a lucky guess. Go on. Reach in, just grab a card, take a card. Go on, take one out. Anyone you like. Okay, is that the four spades?
No.
It would have been good though, wouldn't it? Yeah. I'd have been freaked. I'd have walked out there. There we go. Yeah. You see, I've got a tricky job. I make it look easy, but I'm just showing it's not actually that easy. See, if I wanted to find your card, Cook would have to start again and use the four spades. Do me a favour, write your name on that card for me. Write your name on there.
I've got a pen.
Yeah, you can use mine. There we go. What are you doing?
What pen?
It's a pen.
What pen?
No, use a pen. What are you doing?
I don't know.
Are you his carer? Okay, look, you have to use a Sharpie, it's a marker pen. You take it off, you just write your name with the card, yeah? Write your name on the card for me. Big letters, right across the face. Don't write it on your face. I thought I should clarify that after what's
happened.
On the
face, yeah,
on
the
face of the card, yeah? And then I'm going to take the card. Actually, I'm going to take the pen. So I'm going to take the pen here. No, I meant small, but no, I'm joking. That's great. Hold on. It's even, I've got a spare one. Don't panic. Okay. Now, look. If I take your card here, how many chances are you going to give me to find your card?
Would 52 be too easy?
No, yeah. It's a bit hard.
One.
Ta-da. Good, isn't it? Ah, thank you. Actually, that wouldn't work. Do you know why?
Right.
It's not your card. But for me, the easiest way, just open both your hands together for me.
I don't want to.
Put both hands together. I'm going to take that card. This isn't your card, okay?
Insane.
But we're going to use this to find your card. So if I just do this and that, turn the card over.
Oh, fuck off.
Go on, turn it over. Now, I was confident that was your card, and I knew it was your card. But do you know how I knew it was your card? So if I put it back in the pack and I blow on it, if you watch carefully, every other card vanishes. So there's only one card there. It's actually the only card that I had. And you can keep that as a souvenir. You can clap too, I don't get embarrassed.
Insane. Look at that.
So the second routine we're going to be looking at uses a switch that Wayne developed, and it's a switch of a folded up card. Anyone who knows Christian Grace, you probably know switch one, right? And switch one is an amazing switch. And the thing with switch one is the switch happens here. You focus attention on the card, you open it, and as you open it, it's switched. The switch that Wayne uses, which he actually teaches on the Netrix, woohoo, the switch that Wayne teaches and is using in this particular routine, it's done very much on the offbeat. So the folded up card's put on the table from the beginning. He picks up the folded up card and it shows his hand's empty. And in that action, the switch is done. He's changing the moment that the switch is done. So it becomes more of an offbeat thing as opposed to people laser focused on the unfolding of the card, which is a different approach. And it looks amazing. To be honest, it completely caught me off guard. Now, the other nice thing about this, if you know switch one, you can't really use it as a Mercury card fold switch, because of how the switch takes place. You need it like perfectly scored, whilst with this switch that Wayne does, that's not the case. In fact, he actually uses this in the context of a Mercury in the context of a mystery card, and it's really nice. He puts that down on the table, he does a routine, and at the end that turns into the signed card. Also notice it's the same card and as the first routine you looked at, and the reason is he's one thing that I noticed from Wayne that I got from him is he thinks very carefully about structuring routines together and what routine will go from here to here. And I've talked about this on the channel before when I talk about creating set lists and the importance of transitions and transitioning from one trick to another. Well, that's what you're going to see here. Wayne transitions from one trick to another by using the same card. Okay, so this routine's finished. Now let's do something else. I'm just going to put this card over here. And it's just great. It's one of the strongest mystery cards I've seen. You don't even need a box. Let's have a look at this one. This is routine number two.
So, Matt, I want to use your card again. And okay. I've got a little prediction that I'm going to place here on the table. Okay? Don't worry, it's just an extra card. We can use that. We've still got loads of cards we can use. Yeah? Now, I'm going to try something here with you. And I want you to watch this really closely. Because what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to take your card and I'm going to try and find it by just giving it a little spin like that. So it's somewhere inside the deck. We'll give the cards a couple of cards. Just say stop.
Stop.
Okay, we take this card here, for instance. Now, if I take the nine of hearts, I just give it a little spin like that, it's going to become a card, yeah? And it happens quite cool. Now, I can put it here into the middle, and then we just give it a little riffle like that. So in fact, we riffle it down, it jumps back to the top like that as well. Let's just give it back into the middle. Now, one of my favorite ones to do, if you take the card for me, and if you just say stop.
Stop.
Put the card here. Now check this out, okay? Because I'm going to take the cards. Somewhere in here now is your card, yeah? You baked it in, you saw me riffle on top of it. Somewhere in here, I can't hold on to anything, I can't know where the card could be. Yeah? But watch this. Just say stop one more time.
Stop.
Oh, sorry, that's a bit long there. Turn that card over for me. Okay, let's try this one more time, but I want to do something really, really different here. So I'm going to take your card and I'm going to place it into the middle, okay?
Yeah.
And again, no, it's just in the middle, yeah? We can give it a quick shuffle as well. And all I'd like you to do is I'd like you to think of a number between 1 and 52.
Okay.
Go for it.
41.
41. Take the cards and deal down 41 cards. Go for it.
Fuck off.
Go on.
Really?
Do you want to change your mind? Change to a different number.
Can I change to a different number?
Yeah, go for it.
Do I have to tell you what it is?
Go on. Well, no, just deal down to it. How's that for you? Deal down to the number you're just thinking of.
Really?
Yep. Okay, what was your card? Four spades, wasn't it? Put your name on it.
Yeah.
Turn it over. Oh, that would have been good though, wouldn't it? Now, here's the thing, put the cards down. Stick the card, just stick them down, okay. Open your hand for me. This card has been here the whole time. I did tell you it was my prediction. Now, if I pick this card up, my hands are empty, yeah? And you could have chosen any card, and you wrote your name on the card, and this has been on the table the whole time, and yet, it's your card with your name on it, and you can keep that as a souvenir. Cheers, everyone.
That's not. I put it in the deck.
And that was there the whole time.
No. That's nuts.
So routine number three uses, it's a sandwich routine, basically. It's a three-phase sandwich routine. And it's really strong. It looks a really nice three-phase routine. He calls it the Earl of Sandwich, and it's also another one that we filmed to go on the Netflix. Now, I love the structure of this sandwich routine. And what I want you to pay special attention to is the structure. It's a three-phase routine, and I want you to see that each phase builds, not just builds from a visual aspect, but builds from the point of view of the spectator even being told that each phase is going to be stronger. It's really important that when you're doing multi-phase routines, whether it be ambitious card, card to pocket, card in the box, anything like that, each phase does have to build. And when you're doing a multi-phase sandwich routine, it sometimes makes it very difficult to make each phase build because in essence, you're doing the same thing. The card is appearing between two other cards. So how do you make that routine build? How do you make a routine like that build? Well, this trick that you're about to see, which is one of the launch lineups when Wayne launches his stuff next week on the Netflix, is a perfect example of that. You can see in here, it's a masterclass on how to build a routine and how to go from one routine to another routine to another, how to go from one phase to another phase to another phase and make each phase more impactful than the previous phase. So we're going to have a look at that right now. It's called the Earl of Sandwich. As I say, it will be available on the launch of Wayne's stuff on the Netflix, which is going to be next Monday. Let's have a look at this.
So this is a trick that my friend Peter taught me, and it's a really lovely little thing. We can use your card again, and we've got the full deck here, but I'm actually going to take out two cards. They're at the top there, so that's fine. Will you just check those cards for me? They were together, it was just a coincidence, but can you just make sure they're normal, they're not sticky, there's no other cards stuck to them, they're just the two red jacks, yeah?
Yeah.
And I've gone for the red jacks because you signed a black card for the last trick. So we've got two red jacks and your four spades. I'm going to break the second rule of magic. Do you know the second rule of magic?
I don't know the first one.
Oh, the first rule is you don't tell anyone the secrets.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Second rule is you never repeat a trick.
Oh, okay.
But I'm going to do that.
I know that one.
Yeah, there we go.
Well, first time is entertainment, second time is education.
There we go. Look at that. There we go. You know the third rule of magic?
No.
Something to do with chickens and eggs to wheat ratio. I don't know. Okay, so what we're going to do here is I'm going to do the same trick three times for you. But each time I do it, I'm going to tweak it a little tiny bit. I'm going to make it a little bit more difficult for me to do.
Okay.
And hopefully make it more impressive for you. Okay? That doesn't mean the first time I do this is going to be the weakest one. So I'm going to take your card and I'm going to place it in the middle of the deck. We're going to give the cards a couple of cuts and we're going to give it a shuffle as well to lose the card in there. Is that fair? Yeah. So the card is lost inside the pack, and that leaves us now with these two jacks. And I'm going to use these two jacks to find your card. Okay? So we've got the jack of diamonds and the jack of hearts. And when I click my fingers, one card appears between the two jacks. And if you turn that card over for me and show it to the camera, hopefully that should have your name on it, and it will be your card. And there we go. Boom! Look at that. Nice, isn't it? Let's do it again. Let's make it more difficult now. Okay?
For
you. For me, yeah. So you remember I said I was going to tweak the trick a little bit?
Yeah.
So I'm going to do it again, but this time the jack's on the table and your card is here. Okay? So somehow, I've got to get your card to go from here, and with my hand empty, with my hand empty, somehow get it down here, even though you're watching it the whole time. Okay? Now, the third one's my favourite one, but we need to finish this bit first. So let's check it to the right one. We've got the jack of diamonds, we've got your sign card, and we've got the jack of hearts. This is my favourite one. Are you ready? I want you to count down 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. I'm going to place the card on here. Go for it.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Are you ready? It's back over here already. And if you take the card out for me and show it, go on. It's your card with your name, and it's gone from here. It's completely gone. It's the only one. You only signed one card.
Done. I'm done. I need a new job.
Okay, so trick number 4 is very much a departure from the previous 3 tricks for a couple of reasons. The first reason is it's not his trick. The first 3 tricks are Wayne's own routines, whilst this is a Michael Murray routine from one of his books. And it's a routine I've seen Michael do, and I always forget how good it is. I don't do it myself, but every time I see Michael do it, I always want to learn it because it's brilliant. It uses the springboard principle. And this is something that Michael has explored in very great detail. And Wayne has done it better than anyone I've seen other than Michael, you know, or as good as Michael at any rate. And I want you to see how strong this is and the effect that it has on Matt. In essence, what's happening here is Matt has a freely thought of card and Wayne is able to identify what the freely thought of card is. But there's no peaks. There's no fishing, really. There's nothing. It's this springboard principle that Michael Murray developed that is just genius. Now, what you're seeing Wayne do here is his favourite use of the springboard principle. But Wayne told me after filming that he uses springboard in so many different ways. And one of the key things about the springboard principle is the versatility of how you can use it in various different ways. I mean, just the way that he's using it here is brilliant. Just the way he's using it here is brilliant. It's a way, I mean, the ad copy for this, I mean, think about it. You know, the spectator freely thinks of a card and you can tell them what the card is. I mean, it's amazing, really, when you think about it. The structure is brilliant. And the other thing is it's more cerebral than visual. The first 3 routines were quite visual in nature with cards appearing in between other cards and colour changes and stuff like that. This is more cerebral in nature, but still gets as good as, if not a better reaction from Matt than the visual stuff, which tells you just the impact that mentalism and mental magic and thought of routines can have on somebody if they're presented correctly. Watch the presentation. Even though there's a lot going on from a procedure point of view, it's all interesting. He drags the spectator in and he keeps them engaged the entire way. This is really a masterclass in how to present routines that do have a certain amount of procedure to them.
Okay, Matt, we're going to try something here. I want to try something that's as honest to mind reading as I can get.
Okay.
Okay, all right. What they do is, just say stop.
Stop.
Okay, take that card, do not let me see it. Take it away and stick it in your pocket, stick it somewhere where I can't see what it might be. I don't want to know what colour it is or what suit it is. That's your card. Can you remember that?
Yes.
Okay, before we go any further, I need to verify something as well. You know what all the cards are, the different suits and stuff, yeah? Aces are worth 1. They're not worth 1 or 11. They're 1. Jacks are worth 11. Queens are worth 12. Kings are worth 13. That might become relevant later on. I want you to think of a card as well. And I want you to make sure the card is in the deck. So have a quick look there. Think of a card and just verify that it's in the deck.
Okay.
Yep? Okay. So you've got 2 cards you're thinking of now. Now I'm going to try and make this a bit easier. The card in your jacket is your card. The card you're just thinking of is my card, okay? So, what I'd like to do, I'm going to ask you a couple of questions. They're not too intrusive, and they're to help me create a visualisation, okay? So first of all, the colour of my card, the card that's in here, is it the same colour, as in same like black or red, as the card you've got?
No.
No, okay, so that automatically gets you to question number two, which would be, if you'd have said yes, and I would have gone, oh, is it the same suit? But it can't be because it's a different colour. Okay. The value of my card compared to your card, is it higher, lower, or the same?
Yours is higher.
Mine is higher, okay. And if you were to count up to my card from your card, how much higher would it be? Just too high. Okay, so in your head now, you should have a colour, a suit, and a value. Yeah? You've got, for my card, you should have a colour, a suit,
yeah,
and a value. Okay, so first of all, just think about the colour. Okay. And the suit. And the value. Okay. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go through. I'm just looking for one card. And I really want to just concentrate, just 1 second. Just think about the colour again, just for 1 second. Okay, and the suit. And the value. Okay. I get the feeling that my card might be a red card. Is that correct? Is it right?
Do you want to say hello?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm in the back. Thanks for that. Okay. That's great. That's great. What suit is my card?
You want to tell you?
Yep.
Heart.
It's the heart. Okay. Now I took out one card and placed it on the top. Open your hand for me. Okay. The last question is the most important question because I might have got lucky with those two things. But there's loads of cards here that I could have chosen from. What is the value? This is the all-important question. What is the value of the card that you were just mentally thinking of for me?
Eight.
Eight or ace?
Eight.
Eight. Okay. There's no way I could have known that. There's no way I could have known what colour it was or what suit it was or what value it was. And you just mentally thought of a card and that card was the Eight of Hearts.
Yeah.
I'll just go now. And that's your card, the Eight of Hearts. Or my card, the Eight of Hearts. Boom. But that was just an imagination, a vision inside your head.
How is that possible?
You could have had any single card. And you just thought of that card. That's the most important bit.
I didn't even look at it. I just thought of it. How is that possible?
Okay, so the final routine is another Michael Murray trick. And one thing that I've learned about Wayne is he absolutely loves Michael Murray, and rightfully so. Now, this routine you can get from Magic Box. This is magic. This was created by Michael Murray when he worked for Magic Box. And so it's not a Mind Effects thing. You can't get it from Mind Effects, I don't think. But Magic Box have them in stock. And I actually do this as well. In fact, I've done this on my Magic Box review show special. I actually perform this routine. It's the perfect trick to put in your wallet. You just put it in your wallet and you're ready to go. You just need to carry 10 cards around with you and the little Pepsi logo and you're good to go. This is a perfect example of leading the spectator down a particular garden path. And just when they think they know where things are going, you pull the rug from underneath their eyes and you go in a completely different direction. I think of this as films like Sixth Sense and Fight Club and Unusual Suspects and things like that, where you think you know where things are going, and then all of a sudden at the end, you're completely blown away because it's not what you expected. That's what we're seeing here. You know, at the end, you know, this Pepsi logo has been on display the whole time, and then that's the revelation. I'm not going to ruin it for anybody, but that's such a strong moment. I've performed this myself many, many times. I can't tell you, this is such a strong moment of magic. And the sequence that Michael put together to have a free choice of the numbers and a free choice of the order of the numbers, apparently, is just killer. I mean, it is so killer. Michael is a genius. So let's have a look at this.
So I've got a business card here. This has nothing to do with the trick. Okay. I'm only using this because we've got a brown surface on which you'll be able to see this. I've got this card here. Do you recognise that brand?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, Pepsi. Third most recognised logo in the world. Do you know what the top two are?
Coca-Cola, Apple.
Coke's in banned in most of China. Oh. And that's a massive market. No, it's Apple is second. First.
McDonald's.
Nope. Shell Oil. Not very funny or glamorous, but it is true.
It's a good fact.
I've got a load of cards here, and we've got some numbers on them. We've got fours and twos and sevens and nines, a couple of nines now, I think. What I'm going to do is I'm going to deal the cards out into two piles. Would you like the first pile or the second pile?
Second pile.
Are you sure? Okay. Yeah. So, brands, big brands like Pepsi, they use their logos to influence people. Yeah, you see something and you're instantly, oh yeah, you see a Pepsi, I quite fancy a Pepsi. Yeah, and by recognition and brand recognition, you are heavily influenced. You're the second pile, so I'm going to deal these cards out, and you can see that if you'd have picked the first pile, you would have ended up with a different set of numbers. Yeah?
Yeah.
Now what I'd like you to do is take these cards and hold them in your hand like that. Now we're going to shuffle these up in a bit of a weird way, because I don't want you to think, first of all, I can't control that, I'm going to try and influence you, but you've got to try and beat my influence. So what I'd like you to do is hold the cards like this, and I'd like you to deal the cards down into a nice neat pile on the table and stop whenever you like. Okay, now how many cards you got left in your hand, flip them over and drop them on top. Okay, now pick up the whole thing and you're going to do it again. So just deal them down whenever you want, just stop. And I'll flip them over and drop them on top. And do you want to do it again? Go on, just deal them down, stop whenever you want. And flip them over and drop them on top. Do you want to do it again, or are you happy there?
No, I'm good.
No, did I influence you to stop there?
No.
Did you feel influenced to stop there?
No.
That was a free choice, yeah?
Yeah.
And it's just because there's three colours on the card and we did it three, maybe that might be nothing. Okay, let's have a look here. So we've got some numbers here, let's have a look at them. So we've got 1, 2, 9, 3 and 9. Does that number mean anything to you? Is it a telephone number? 01293 9. Is it a date of birth of a parent or grandparent? Is it part of a passport number or a sort code? Is it let's have a look here, yeah, like a passport thing, or is it a driver license number? No. And even if it was, there's no way I could have known that, and you decided how to mix the cards up. You created this order, and 12939 is just a random number that you came up with. You didn't even know you'd come up with it. Is that fair to say?
Yeah.
And you weren't influenced to get to that position?
No.
And that's completely free choice?
Yeah.
And you really believe that, don't you?
I'm starting not to.
Well, no, you really believe that this was complete chance and complete fair, you know, it just happened, yeah? And I didn't influence you. You didn't feel me pressuring you to stop at any point?
No.
Because if that was true, I mean, if that was really, really true, then this would be impossible. One, two, nine, three, nine.
Oh my God. That's epic.
And just remember that if you'd have chosen these cards, you'd have ended up with a completely different selection of numbers.
That's so clever. Wow. Pepsi, 12939.
So there you go, guys. That's a Wayne Goodman special, 5x5 special. Now, I said this when I did this on Nemed. Do you want me to do this again? Is this something that you would like to see? It takes a while because I have to wait until I see a magician who's got five tricks that I think would be worthy. And then I have to go and take them for dinner and I have to film them. So there's a lot that goes into this. But if you'd like to see me do this in the future, please let me know. Like, I'm at Alakazam next week. Would you like me to sit down with Peter Nardi and get him to do five tricks? Would that be of interest for you? You know, I'm seeing Lloyd in a couple of weeks. Would you like me to do this with Lloyd? Let me know in the comments down below. And also, Wayne will probably see this. Give him some love. Let me know what you think of him down below. And let me know if you're excited about him joining the Netflix and seeing all of his content. We filmed so much stuff. How Wayne was able to speak at the end of the filming schedule, I don't know. Guys, do me a favour. If you want to join the Netflix, please go to www.thenetflix.com. And you can access it right now and see all the fuss is about. All of Wayne's stuff is going to be on the bronze level. And if you want to see more videos like this, like the video, subscribe to the channel. I'll be back again tomorrow at 6 o'clock with another Magic Live. I'll see you then.